So if you're watching this video, you're probably a photographer or a videographer or some sort of person in the creative field. You've more than likely been presented with a situation where you're thinking, should I do this job for free? Should I charge for this? It can get a little bit tricky to judge. So in today's video, I'm going to be giving you 5 reasons why you should work for free. Let's roll the intro. Welcome back to the channel, guys. Thank you very much for joining me here for another video. It's nice to meet you. If we are just meeting, my name is Connor Wells. I am a photographer, videographer, and podcast producer, making all sorts of different content relating to those 3 subjects. So if that's what you're into, please do hit that big red button that says subscribe on it. That would help me out a whole bunch. Anyway, let's get on with the video. So it's always tricky figuring out whether you should or should not work for free. So I'm going to be giving 5 reasons why you should work for free. And if you would like a follow-up video of 5 reasons why you shouldn't work for free, let me know in the comments down below. But let's start with 1, building your portfolio. You need to build a great portfolio to get clients. But also, on the other hand, you need clients to build your portfolio. It's a classic chicken egg situation we've got right here. The simple solution for that is offer photography in return for portfolio material. I did do a lot of shoots before the big bad no-no coronavirus took hold and ruined the music scene. I used to do a lot of live music photography and live music filming. Often, I would do that for free in order to build up my live music section of my portfolio. And in return, bands and artists, singers and soloists would get photos of their gig being captured by myself. I'd obviously add a small little watermark, that way when they share those photos I also get a little bit of exposure. As much as I hate that word when it comes to being a creative and a freelance working for exposure, it's a frowned upon word. We don't say that around here. It's always a good thing. Add your watermark to it, and on a plus, I get some stuff for my portfolio, which will eventually lead to some paid jobs. 2, testing, 1, 2, 3, testing. Even more established photographers sometimes need to do free shoots. It could be as simple as testing out a new camera or trying a new technique. I'm planning on getting a couple of new cameras soon, and the last thing I would want to do is go straight into a paid client shoot with those cameras with little to no experience of actually operating them and using them in the real world. So what can you do there? You can offer a free shoot. With a free shoot, there's no pressure of a paid result, if you know what I mean. There's no pressure of someone paying and expecting something in particular. With a free shoot, you can spend as much or as little time as you want testing out the camera. The model or whoever you're shooting may have to bear with you as you learn the new menu system or learn how it operates and just sort of getting that, you know, muscle memory with that camera. It's a great way to test out new equipment before you actually start taking it into the real world and using it on big paid shoots. 3, time for... you could offer your time in exchange. You can offer your time in exchange for something other than money. It's not all about money. Bartering has been around since the dawn of time. However, there are more creative ways in which you can offer your photography services in exchange for more than just money. Like we mentioned at the start with portfolio building, this can also be another great way to get something in return for your time. One thing I see a lot in the area where I live is photographers and videographers will offer their time to, for example, personal trainers. Instead of charging the personal trainer and invoicing them for the shoot, for the photos, what they could do in exchange is offer, I will give you 50 photos or 1 or 2 videos for your Instagram feed in return for, let's say, 5 1-hour personal training sessions. Like I said, it's not all about money, and you could offer your time for exchange for something else. So you could get in contact with gyms, local gyms, and you could say, I'll make a video for you to plug and boost on social media as an ad. You know, I can get some photos for you for Instagram for a whole year if you give me a membership. Pretty simple, really. 4, charity. I always believe you should photograph things you actually believe in. If I can help a charity that I actually believe in, I will do it for free. As much as it won't pay the bills, working for a charity will give you a feeling that money cannot replace. And 5, for the thrill of it. I think it's really, really important to make sure you still have that passion for photography and not just make it a job. We all started creating and taking photos for a reason, because we love to create, because we love capturing moments, making memories. Don't ever let that slip away. Don't let the passion of photography become a job. Yes, you want it to be a career, and by my guessing, a very successful career, But success isn't always defined by money. Success can just be defined by enjoying the moment, taking a great photo of your friends, your family, your friend's business, for example. Support them and they will support you. And if you're doing it for fun, it'll make it even more worthwhile. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you got some value from it, please do hit the like button. And if you'd like to see a follow-up of some reasons why you shouldn't work for free, let me know in the comments below. That would really, really help me out a bunch. And if you are new here, please do hit that subscribe button. Thank you very much for watching. My name is Connor Wells. If you'd like to see my work and my portfolio, in which some of those photos I did take for free, you can check it out all at connorwells.com. The link will be in the description. Thanks very much for watching. Stay safe and have a great day. See ya.